Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of OEM TV. My name is Eric Mills. I do Windows Server Marketing here at Microsoft. And in this video, we're going to be talking about how you connect Windows Server Essentials Edition up to Azure Backup. Now, Paul's going to take you through the different concepts that you need to be familiar with. As you know, Windows Server Essentials is that great first server for a small company that's just buying, you know, their first server that they've ever had. It has a limit of 25 users and it's very inexpensive. A nice thing about Essentials is it can be connected up to Azure to do your backups, both your client backups and your server backups. So Paul's going to talk about what that looks like, how it's typically configured. You have several different options when you set the backup up, so he'll take you through some of those options and make some recommendations on the configuration. You can back up different types of files. You can have different settings on the restoration that are that's available. So a lot of different options that you can take a look at before you actually set things up. So a lot of people are using Azure Backup, both for client and server backups, as just a way to get their data offsite in case of a disaster, or just to have a nice offsite backup at a very low cost. There are some limitations in it as well that Paul will go through, but overall, this should be a really good overview video if you're not that familiar with Azure Backup and Windows Server Essentials. So I hope you enjoy the video. See you next time on OEM TV.
Hello, everyone. In this quick video, we'll take a look at Windows Server 2016 Essentials Edition and Azure Backup integration. First, let's look at Windows Server 2016 Essentials from a high level. So the main things Windows Server 2016 Essentials can do is help you safeguard your business, improve IT efficiency and productivity, and then also get you ready for the cloud. And if we break that down a little further, under safeguard your business, there's certainly, once you implement it, there's easy permission settings. There's this concept of just in time and just enough administration. Then there's also Windows Defender for malware protection built in, and you also have trusted and secure boot for your server system. And then in improve IT efficiency and productivity, there's a new enhanced management experience with the Essentials dashboard. And then there's built-in services to help meet the needs of small businesses, things like file shares, a web server, Active Directory, certificate services, a local desktop backup, remote desktop services, and also PowerShell enhancements to improve the overall productivity and ease of use of your server's essential environment. And then to help you get ready for the cloud, there's easy Microsoft Cloud integration. So there's Azure Active Directory integration, there's Azure Backup and Storage, Azure Virtual Networks, Azure Site Recovery, Office 365, Microsoft Intune, and then remote management tool integration as well. So you can manage your server from the cloud if that's what you decide to do. And for this discussion, we'll be looking at Azure Backup and Storage. So for small organizations, there are a lot of backup challenges, and really most small businesses don't even back up their data, which is quite dangerous to say the least. So it's really costly and complex to, you know, first deal with the growing amount of business data that every organization has to deal with. And then you also would have to buy and manage disk and tape solutions to back the data up and keep that data. Once you've backed it up on some medium, whether that's tape or disk, you have to store that data safely from theft or loss. And then you also have to keep that data safe from natural disasters. And in many cases, you have to treat that data differently because you have to meet new regulations for compliance. All of these things add to the cost and complexity and really difficulty of backing up the data and then storing the data and keeping it safe. With Windows Server 2016 Essentials, there's actually several backup solutions that are available. The first one is Server Backup, the ability to back up your essential server system directly to an external USB drive. And then there's the Client Computer Backup, where you can actually back up and restore the client computers in the network on the server running Windows Server Essentials. So all of your network devices can back up images, they can back up data, whatever you need to do in your local environment. And then there's also Microsoft Azure Backup. So you can then take your Windows Server Essentials server and back it up directly to Microsoft Azure. And there's significant benefits in doing that, and we'll look at some of those. In this diagram on the left, you can see the on-premises devices can back up directly to the server, but then also the server can then be backed up into Azure, which can be a very effective backup solution. So for Azure backup, we're looking at it as a backup as a platform. So in this case, it's pay as you go. You only have to pay for what you use, what you need. There's no infrastructure for backup per se. You just need a network connection and you can do the backup. And there's no storage egress charges. Now this just takes a little bit of explanation. There's what we call ingress charges into Azure and then egress charges. So ingress is bringing data into Azure. Egress is bringing data out of Azure. And then there's also a single management pane so that you can see the actual backups and the data, and you can examine the data and on and on. And then it's also self-service. You can go in very easily and set up the backup solution and just begin using it. And then also this concept of it being beyond backups. Backup is just a portion of certainly of what Azure can do. So there's this integration with Azure services. If your data is in Azure, you can actually do analytics on it if that's what you want to do. Or you can monitor that data. So you can monitor how much and what type of data that you're putting in Azure. Then again, you have the insights and analytics. And then you can leverage Azure identity and security services. And that could be single sign-on to other applications, allowing other applications to access that data, or whatever it is that you want to really do with that data in the context of the Azure environment. So looking at it again from the perspective of data protection with Azure Backup, on the left you have the on-premises environment, and then it's connected to the cloud. And so you're backing up to the cloud, you have off-site and long-term protection. And then you also have protection from malware because that data is segregated. It is separate from your on-prem environment. So you have the ability to back up. You have the ability to restore either individual files or folders. And the environment is secure. And you also have the ability to monitor that data and do reporting on that data. How much data, when, what type of data, and many more objects to report on. Okay, so this concept of a backup as a service where you can optimally protect your data. Again, you've got the on-premise environment backing up to Azure. There's protection from deletion or corruption. There's application consistent backup, meaning if you've got a particular application that you want to back up to Azure, that data will be consistent in the backup. Then you can back up without shutting down your environment. It just runs in the background. And then you have this concept of data retention for compliance. So if there's So if you're in an environment where you're governed by certain regulations and you have to maintain data for some period in order to be compliant, Azure Backup can help you there as well. So there's no additional infrastructure needed. You have what you need. If you have a network connection, you have what you need in order to start using Azure Backup. And then it's very simple to configure. There's a download of an agent onto the server. You have to obviously create a backup vault, a storage vault inside Azure itself, connect the two, and you can start backing up right away. And then these backups are relatively fast. Naturally, you're limited by the line speed between your on-premises environment and Azure. But if you're doing incremental backups, you can see how quickly that might happen, where you're only, after the first backup, you're only sending up changes to your data. And that makes it much faster than if you're sending the entire amount of data. And then this concept of self-service backup and restore, you can do it yourself. It's very easy. And there's also restore as a service. So you can optimally restore your data as well. You can do a file or folder level restore. You can inspect the data before restoring it to make sure it's the right type of data, the right size. And then these fast restores from cloud endpoints. So there's multiple cloud endpoints that Microsoft provides in its infrastructure that allow you to back up. You're not necessarily going across the country or across the world to access the backup environment. The Azure endpoints are located in many cities throughout the world. That allows you to have a closer endpoint for access to the data that's backed up in the cloud. And then no additional infrastructure is needed. As long as you've got a network connection, you can go ahead and restore back to your Windows Server Essentials environment. And then you also have the ability to do reporting across both the on-premises data environment and the cloud environment, and even bring in Power BI. Again, for this type of reporting, there's no additional infrastructure needed. These central reports can span the entire hybrid IT deployment, meaning the on-prem environment and the cloud environment. And there's a content pack from Microsoft with default reports, so you can create your own reports and visualizations with Power BI. And then there's certainly customizable reports with Power BI as well. This gives organizations of all sizes the ability to create reports and visualize the data that they're using in their environment. So in summary, with Windows Server 2016 Essentials, there's multiple backup solutions. That could be a local USB drive, backing up the local client to the Windows Server 2016 Essentials box, or Azure Backup. And then Azure Backup obviously provides many benefits. It's off-site and it's secure. It provides compliance in Azure, and you actually even have the ability to access the reports and the compliance documents for Azure and the Azure infrastructure to help you be compliant in your own business. And then that also has role-based management where only certain people can have access to the backups and restores. Again, the self-service concept. And then you can also create and view reports. So all in all, it's a very flexible backup environment that includes not only on-premises types of backup, but also cloud backup. With that, thank you very much.